Welcome back and thank you so much to Tsietsi. Now, former AU chairperson Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma has accused Model C schools of being anti-ANC. Well, speaking at the ANC's cadres assembly in Zamdela, Free State, just a few days ago, the presidential hopeful said that children were being taught against the ANC in schools. And this, she says, explains why children believe that the ANC is actually corrupt and useless. Dlamini-Zuma has been rallying support ahead of the ANC conference in December, and now joining us to dissect this issue on education and what is actually in the curriculum is educational activist Hendrick Makaneta. A very good morning to you, Hendrick. Thank you so much for joining us and welcome to the show.
Good morning, Simpiwe, and of course to the viewers at home.
Indeed, indeed. Now, Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma suggests that the educational system should be transformed. So what do you think are the dangers then of the ANC transforming the system presents, particularly in the current political climate?
Yeah, well, I want to agree with Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma that, you know, there are many schools, particularly those former Model C schools, as well as private schools, which are actually teaching learners to hate the ANC. And, you know, we've seen many examples, for example, of racism in schools such as Kuro, where learners were even separated, you know, in as far as race is concerned. Mm. And we really think that the government has put in place the correct policy. For example, CAPS, a policy of government, is correct. You know, its intention is very good because it seeks to establish an inclusive education system which does not look at, you know, race or social standing in society. Mm. But of course, like any other policy, these are policies that are often abused by those who are supposed to implement, example, teachers and so on and so forth. You have seen also in Girls High, Pretoria Girls High, where learners, particularly black African learners, were made to feel inferior. You know, their culture is made to feel inferior. So what we need as a country is to ensure that we monitor, you know, the implementation of these good policies, sure, in different schools. Okay. Because, you know, some of them, for example, you'll find that a teacher goes into the classroom and teach learners, you know, that the president, for example, is corrupt. And, you know, once you cascade this kind of information to learners, you are building a society that will be divided, not the one that we seek to create.
Mm-hmm. Let's now get to the bolts and the nuts of Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma's statement. What, in pragmatic terms, does she mean when she talks of when she calls for a transformation in the education system?
Well, like I've already indicated, she wants us to build an inclusive education system. Mm. And what do we mean by inclusive education system? That will be the system of education that take into cognizance, you know, our diversity, principles of diversity as well as collaboration, that, you know, learners must feel safe first and foremost in the classrooms or in the schools, and they must feel valued. All learners must feel that they are valued and that all learners must have access to the same curriculum. Mm. Of course, we recognize the you know, the great step that government has taken to eradicate the legacy of apartheid in as far as the curriculums are concerned. You'll recall that, you know, during apartheid, we had different curriculums. Each and every, you know, we had Bantu education, you know, Transkei, Botswana. Each and every state back then had its own curriculum. Mm-hmm. Now, the curriculum that we have now, CAPS, is a very good curriculum, but the key challenge is implementation. Remember, yeah, that the final product, the teacher in the classroom, is the one who implements.
Yes.
So whatever is taking place in the classrooms, that is what, you know, it depends on the teacher. So monitoring of that particular curriculum is going to be important for us. I think that is what Dr. Nkosazana seeks to you know, to cascade to the nation as well.
Okay. Now, Professor Ruxana Osment, let me just quote her verbatim, Dean of Humanities at the Wits University, says, government cannot intervene in what is taught in schools along party lines. And she goes on to further state that, especially when we see ourselves as a democracy. Is propaganda really in schools, is it really propaganda to be imparting a particular political narratives onto schools?
Well, not necessarily. It's not propaganda. You know, that makes me to go back to an issue that was raised earlier on, that there are parents, for instance, in the country who do no longer take their kids to government schools because they believe that it is ANC propaganda that is taught in the classroom. Mm. But the reality is that the ANC is the one that has set an African child free. We cannot move away from that. Our learners need to be taught where we come from. That's why earlier on, 2 weeks ago, we called for, you know, government to ensure that each and every child learns about the history, particularly South African history, the ANC history included. We cannot shy away from that. Our learners need to know that it was the ANC that set them free. Mm. It was the ANC that created this non-racial, this united society. They need to know about it, and that is not propaganda, because society was divided along racial lines. And you know, today we see people trying to take us back to where we were before. For example, we condemned earlier the call by Wits University on the other day, which was instigating their students to go and march on the 7th of April to march against a duly elected president of the Republic. And we think that is wrong. You know, institutions should not be doing that.
In actual Hendrick, if you believe that it is not propaganda teaching a particular political narratives in school, so do you think Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma would hold a different view if anti-DA sentiments were shared in schools or anti-EFF sentiments were being taught in schools?
We are saying that, of course, you know, teachers should not teach learners to be anti-EFF or anti-DA or anti-ANC. They must teach the curriculum. The curriculum is there, it's embedded, but they must teach it properly. They must implement it properly, unlike the current state, whereby learners are asked, for example, who is the president of the country? A learner will say, it's Jacob. And then they'll say, what do you know about...
Even if that that curriculum is of a prevailing political narrative, that it should still be taught.
Well, I'm saying that we should not shy away from the truth.
Okay.
The truth and the reality of the matter is that the ANC is the one that is an organization that liberated South Africa. Mm. Therefore, learners need to know these things. We need to teach them that it was this President Jacob Zuma who led from the front. The violence that we had, for instance, in KwaZulu-Natal, President Jacob Zuma was able to make a decisive intervention there to make sure that at the end of the day, there is peace and you know, unity there in the province. Mm. And that is what learners need to know, and not what some of the teachers are currently trying to do, to move learners away from you know, this history, you know, to portray the organization of the African National Congress as this corrupt organization that must be, you know, dismantled. Mm. That is not what we stand for. We think that that must be done away with, and of course we need to find a way to transform this education system to make sure that it becomes an embodiment of the concepts of unity as well as collaboration and of course diversity included.
Yeah. So what is the case then at universities? Does the government have the powers to regulate what is being taught there in that space?
Well, in institutions of higher learning, the biggest thorn has been institutional autonomy, where you know, the Senate of the university as well as the council decide what is taught there and decide on a number of policy directives. But we have been engaging the Ministry of Higher Education at that level as well to make sure that there is broader transformation of our universities, hence the recent bill that was adopted into law, the Higher Education, the Amendment Bill. And we are really saying that, you know, it will take some time before we really, you know, come to a stage where our universities are transformed fully.
DA MP Gavin Davis says it is a direct attack on Basic Education Minister Angie Motshekga that she's actually not doing her job when Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma calls for a total transformation of the education system. What's your take on that?
Well, I think that the minister Angie Motshekga has done a lot in as far as the CAPS document is concerned, you know, bringing together, you know, ensuring that we have got a policy document which speaks of accommodates all learners who must have access. But of course, you know, more can still be done. I think that, you know, where there are problems, they must be raised. It does not mean that when we raise issues, it means that the minister is not effective. Mm-hmm. You know, where we need changes, such changes must be effected. And of course, total transformation or radical transformation of the education system is necessary in this space to make sure that our learners are taught in such a way that they appreciate where we also come from as a country and not the divisive elements that we see in schools such as Kuro, some private schools, as well as Model C schools. For example, in Gauteng, we all know the MEC, the Panyazalisuf, has been battling to transform some of these schools. At some point, we all know they took him to court just to make sure that they remain a preserve of the white community. So I'm saying that we still have a long way really to transform our system of education broadly in the country.
So what then is the policy position in terms of politicizing the curriculum in schools?
Well, you can't run away from politics. That is one of the realities. And when we say that the ANC has delivered, basic education, for example, opening the doors of learning for those who come from poor communities. We are telling the truth. I don't know whether anyone must say we are politicizing education when we say it was the ANC that opened the doors of learning. If you look at universities such as the University of Pretoria, black people were not allowed to go there. And then the ANC came and said, that must stop. We are opening all doors for poor students. Black students did not have money to study, and the ANC came in and said, let us ensure that we fund primarily those who come from a poor backgrounds. And I don't know whether that can be called politicizing education.
All right, unfortunately we have to end it there. Hendrick, thank you so much. It's been great chatting to you this morning. All right, that was educational activist Hendrick Makaneta. Well, Hendrick is an education activist in the terrain of basic and higher education in South Africa. He holds a bachelor's degree in mathematics from the University of Pretoria, and he is from the Education for Social Justice Foundation. We do thank him for his views on Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma's recent call that the entire education system needs to be transformed. All right, Morning Live takes a break now, and after the break, we will cross over to Vuani. Well, this is Morning Live. We'll be back.